is a woman? What does it mean to be a woman? A woman is one of the most beautiful creations of God. There's more to a woman than just biology. Hello and a very warm welcome to all the lovely viewers of Doordarshan. I'm Riddhi Sharma. And today we have a very special person with us, a lady, a multifaceted lady with us, who is not only the director of the National Book Trust of India, she is also a noted Assamese writer. She is the winner of the prestigious Sahitya Academy Award, an activist, and she has also been an associate professor of political science at Cotton College, Guwahati.
Dr. Rita Chowdhury, born at Nampong of Tirup district in Arunachal Pradesh. She is an established poet, novelist and Sahitya Academy Award recipient in the world of Assamese literature. She has been working as an associate professor in Cotton College, Guwahati, Assam, in Political Science Department since 2001. Prior to that, Chowdhury had worked as lecturer from 1991 to 1996 and as senior lecturer from 1996 to 2001 in the same college. She started her teaching career as lecturer in political science in the Ipu Government College, Karbi and Law, from the year 1989 to 1991. She is currently the director of National Book Trust of India. She is the wife of ex-minister of Assam, Sri Chandra Mohan Patwari. She never does any injustice to her characters, although there is a subterranean flow of feminism in some of her novels. She is reflecting the reality only.
The roles are so many, but the woman is one. Yes, the name is Dr. Rita Chowdhury. A very warm welcome to you, ma'am. They say that a journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. Talking about your literary career, what was that first step and how did you take that?
It was just accident that I become a novelist. Okay. It was during the Assam movement. I wrote my first novel. I was an activist of Assam movement.
Okay.
So I was very young that time. Then there's an announcement from Assam Sahitya Sabha. It's a very big literary organization. They announced a competition of a manuscript. The subject was Assam movement.
Okay.
So I thought that I could write a novel. But before that I did not write any novel or any short stories also.
Okay.
But I decided I could write, and so I started writing. That time I had to shift my places from one town or one village to another village. So it was a time of social movement.
The Assam movement or Assam agitation from 1979 to 1985 was a popular movement against undocumented immigrants in Assam. The movement, led by All Assam Students Union, AASU, and the All Assam Ganasangram Parishad, AAGSP, developed a program of protests and demonstration to compel the government to identify and expel illegal immigrants. The agitation program ended in August 1985 following the Assam Accord, which was signed by leaders of AASU, AAGSP and the Government of India. The agitation leaders formed a political party, Assam Gana Parishad. It came to power in the state of Assam in the assembly elections of 1985 and later in 1996. The parliament passed the Illegal Migrants Determination by Tribunals Act IMDT in October 1983 and began to implement it in Assam. Negotiations took place between the government and AASU, AAGSPO during the later parts of 1984 and first part of the year 1985. In May 1985, Formal talks started and Home Secretary led the central government team. Several rounds of talks took place during May, June and July 1985. Initially, the Assam coalition wanted immigrants from the 1961-71 waves to be disfranchised and dispersed to other areas of the country. By August 1985, they had agreed to a new cut-off date of January 1966. Immigrants who had entered illegally after that were to be detected and deported and disfranchised for 10 years. On August 15, the historic Assam Accord was signed in presence of the then Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi. During the years of protest, 855 people had died.
So in this period, I wrote the novel in different places. Then I got the first prize in this competition and I became a novelist. Then their pressure started coming. Then I wrote another novel, but it was not very good. Then after 10 years, again, I took the pen very seriously and started writing again. Then that was a actual journey. That journey started in during Assam movement, but my actual journey started in 90s. Then I worked, I wrote a few novels. So journey is still going on.
Yes, it's still going on. Your first novel was Abhirat Yatra.
Yes.
What is it about?
It is about some moment. The subject was some moment. So it was a competition. So my experience as a young activist about society, about people, because I came out from the boundary of very normal home life.
Okay.
See, I have a young girl. There was in 1980s. You can imagine about the society. So I came out from this boundary, and entered into a greater space. I came to know about different places, different people. I gathered extensive knowledge about the society and the people. I think that is the beginning of a new person. A new person was born in a social movement. And I become a very committed writer. So from movement, there was a big space. Then after that, I made my pen as my platform, and I work from this platform, and I am a very socially committed writer. I am committed to this world, committed to my society, and I work from my platform. Now again, I have become the director of NBT.
Yes.
So this is again, I have got a bigger space to serve my society, serve the world through, especially in the world of books.
So you've always wanted to contribute your bit to the society?
Yes.
And that's what your writing is all about?
Yes. I write, generally I try to write on behalf of those, maybe as a living thing or non-living thing, who don't have their voice, or who cannot raise their voice, suppose a tree, a river, a community. So I feel it from, if you can say, it's from my soul, that I should serve. I have a mission. So this is my mission, that I have a very, God has given me, or the nature has given me a power to express. So I express. When I express, I don't think about myself. I think about my surroundings. And I think that the strength I have, the very, very little strength, I should use for a greater cause. So I pick up the different social issues and write a novel on them, on these issues, so that it can reach the readers. They can feel, they can raise a voice for these people or different other things for whom I am writing.
So it would not be wrong to say that you become a voice for the voiceless. Those who don't have a voice, you are their voice.
See, I am not a voice, but my pen is the voice.
Yeah, obviously, yeah. Through your pen.
Through my pen.
Yes.
I try to speak for these people or on behalf of those who cannot speak. Cannot speak means who don't have a voice or who cannot assert their rights, who cannot save themselves. Yeah. For these people, I try to write, like throw away children, like the rivers, like the communities who are marginalized. So I try to write.
Talking about that competition, that was Assam Sahitya Sabha. Did you ever think that you would win the competition?
I did not think anything. Actually, I was just writing the novel. I did not have any idea about writing a novel.
Mm-hmm.
Because there is no training, there is no guide. So I had the novel and just send it to the Assam Sahitya Sabha. Then I was in jail that time, and I got the first prize.
You were in jail?
Yeah.
Why were you in jail?
Because I took part in the Assam agitation to expel the foreigners. Foreigners meant illegal infiltrators. So because of that, like many other activists, I was also arrested and I was put in jail.
So who received it on your
My
behalf?
Mother.
Your mother received it.
Yes. I was very young that time.
And at that young age you were in jail?
Yeah, I was only 20 years.
How long were you kept in jail?
For three months I was
3
in jail.
Months?
Yeah.
So that would have been a very...
It was a great experience.
Great experience?
Yeah, yes, it's a very great experience. As, see, what I am now working, that I am writing, these are the contribution that I just experienced in jail, experience during the time of absconding, meeting different kind of people, seeing different level of life, seeing the, like that experiencing poverty, hunger, insecurity. So these are the experience which enriches me as writers. So I take it as a very great experience in my life. That I took part in a social movement for a greater cause. I was arrested, but many people sacrificed their life. So I don't consider myself as a great activist, but I was a part of the movement. And that is as a student. So it was a great experience for me. So I did not feel that my mother took the prize on my behalf.
You wanted to receive it?
I did not feel like that because I was very involved with the movement. I was in jail. I was just living with many under trial prisoners, some women who were given life imprisonment, and some women were not mentally not well. They were also put in a jail. There's a very different experience for me. So I'm very much enriched because of this different. No one can see these people inside a jail. This is a different world, and coming out from the boundaries of your very common and stereotype family life, coming out of the boundary, that breaking the normal boundary of normal life, it definitely you have to come out, you have to break your boundaries to learn, to see the world from a higher
different
level
perspective,
to understand the world, to look at life from a different perspective.
Yeah.
So you have to enhance your perspective, understanding, or that you're learning, so that you can write, if you have a clear understanding where you are going. Suppose many people, they don't know where to go, what to do, what is the purpose of their life. But I am very much clear. I know what to do, why I am here, what is my responsibilities, what are my limitations, what are my strengths. I know where to go. So that way, I am very much clear about life.
So as a writer, every experience, whether good or bad, it is an asset for a writer.
Yes, all the experience. Sometimes when that I am going through the experience, I feel the pain. Yes. I have that pain. But later on, I feel that pain also is an experience.
Yes.
Yeah. So this empowers me. And in my writing, I try to write about that empowerment of women, especially what my understanding about empowerment, if you want to ask me about.
Yes.
What I feel as a woman, you are speaking about that every woman has as a speciality. So I feel that it starts from self-respect. First, you have to respect yourself first thing. When you respect yourself, then the process of empowerment begins. For everyone, not only a woman, but for the man also. When you respect yourself, you will protect your self-respect. That means you will not do certain things, see, which are not good for the community, for the greater life. So you will not compromise certain things. So it starts from self-respect. It is not about money. It's not about position. Empowerment begins from self-respect, that I believe. And because I believe in this thing, that I respect myself, so I am here.
Absolutely.
This is the journey of a woman. That is a start from this point, the point of self-respect.
And that's what we find in most of your books. In most of your books, the protagonists are strong women. Right?
Yes.
So that is also empowering them.
Yes. My novels are mainly, I try to speak in a very positive way, to try to encourage. I try to say that life is beautiful. That is my final say, that we are born, that we are not born without any meaning. There's a meaning of life.
Right.
So what is the meaning? Everyone is assigned certain duties.
Yes.
I know what is my duty. I'm doing my duty. That's why that after a very long journey, I'm here facing you, answering your questions.
That's exactly what every woman needs to do.
Yes.
Identify what's special in her, what's unique about her.
Yes.
Because no two women are the same. Everyone is different from one another.
Everyone has some speciality.
Yes, right.
Everyone, not the woman only. He or she has to find out that speciality and try to grow on that particular aspect.
Yes. You received the Sahitya Academy Award for your novel Diolankui.
Yes.
That is the Divine Sword.
Divine Sword.
Yeah. So how easy or difficult was it to write the novel? Tell us something about it.
This is very interesting. This is it is based on oral traditions and history. It is about a royal family. That's a Tiwa community, very small community. And I tried to depict a bigger picture. The backdrop was big. That is the society of that period, 700 years back. How the small communities live together peacefully. There is no communal writing kind of thing. So I thought that I should think about how these people, there was a, you know, there was a place called Jaggi Road. We can see that summit, international summit, the position, the people, the representative of different countries, how they sit, there is equality.
Right.
And the tribal kings, they used to sit like that. And they decided and solved all their issues on this discussion table so many years back. And I tried to write against war, against violence. I tried to write about love. And it is about the, I tried to depict the culture of that community. Different aspects I covered in that novel.
Another very popular novel of yours is Makam.
Yes.
Which got you a lot of great national and international acclaim.
Yes.
What is it about?
It is about the Indian Chinese, especially the Assamese Chinese. The Assamese Chinese is a community. It's not Chinese. It's a part of the greater Assamese identity. In when tea was the Robert Bruce, he discovered tea in the Singpho Kingdom in Assam, just into that period of Assam. Then the tea industry started in Assam. So British brought the Chinese people to develop the tea industry, to establish tea industry in Assam. So Chinese people came from different parts of the world, from Kuli Depot, from Calcutta, from South China. So they married local maidens.
Okay.
And they that one new society. And they also married the people who were brought from different parts of British India to work in the tea industry. They married this girl from that community also, tea community now you say. And a new society was formed. But in 1962, they were arrested. And they arrested, and those, they thought that they were Indians. They were left behind, and some were arrested and sent to the Delhi internment camp in Rajasthan, and from there they were sent back to China. After 3-4 generations they lived there. So in this process families were divided. So
yeah.
I have written about the plight of the Assamese Chinese. They were part of the Indian identity, but they suffered a lot due to the war. They were not at fault. They are our own people. So this book changed the perspective of our society. Now again there's a revival of the old old relationship, all that warmth, that love. So I believe that a pen can change the course of a society or a time, course of of an issue. So
pen is mightier than a sword.
Always.
Yes. And later you also made a documentary based on Makam.
Yes.
Titled Wars and Tears.
Yes.
That you have translated it in English, right?
The documentary is based on the interview I took during my research when I was writing.
Okay.
Makam. And there's a coffee table book which is based on the same issue, but I have added there some very rare documents.
Which genre do you write in, and what is the most dominant theme of most of your novels? You write fiction?
Generally, I write novels. Sometimes the characters are true, sometimes the characters are half, that is based on a real character. Sometimes I have to conceal the identity.
Mm-hmm.
Generally, my stories are based on reality. But it is the base, the facts are, or the basic facts or the reality. I construct my novel, or I write my novels. Most of my novels, it is everywhere, generally. Through your children, is a reality. You can find it everywhere. People abandon their child. Some say it's a reality from you know, like terrorism is also a reality everywhere. So I write against terrorism. So there, these are the issues I take generally.
Novels for children, ever thought of that?
See, to write a novel or anything for children is very difficult. So I don't think that I am that powerful writer. I will try to write a novel for the children. That I have a son and a daughter. I have seen how they grow, their questions, their confusions, their dilemmas, everything I have seen, and the transition of time. So I'll try, but I don't know. I don't know whether it will be possible to write, like understanding their mind. It is very difficult. So definitely I'll try to write a novel for the growing children especially, because they face so many questions. There have so many confusions which they cannot share with their parents.
Right.
So for this confusing part of the young people, I'll definitely try to write, because I have seen these realities from a very close range.
How long does it take you to write a novel?
It depends on the subject. Sometimes it takes 2-3 days for a small novel, but for Makam it takes 4 years.
4 years.
Yeah. Extensive research. So it depends on the issue. To write a novel on Assam movement is very easy for me, because I know, I have seen it. But to take up a different issue, I have to do research, so it takes time. So it depends on the subject.
And what about a poem?
Actually, I'm a poet, but now I'm known as a novelist in Assam, especially. I write poems also, but now I feel when I write a poem, I feel that when I cannot express in prose, then poetry starts.
Yes.
This is my personal observation and feeling and understanding, that poetry is first, and poetry can cover entire life. Sometimes prose may not express our feelings, but poetry can. So it is my personal opinion, it may be wrong, but when I write poem, I feel that when I cannot express my feelings in prose, then I automatically I write poems.
So how long does it? Yeah. So how long does it take you to write a poem?
Sometimes it takes a minute. Generally.
A minute.
Sometimes it takes 10 minutes, because you see, when I don't take long time to write a poem. When I feel that it comes from my soul.
Within, yes.
Yeah. So it automatically comes. It doesn't take much time to write a poem for me, but I rarely write poems, because I can write a poem, but only when I feel nowadays, because I am focusing more on novels. So only when I feel that hours come from inside, then only I write from my within. It comes from within.
You have 4 poetry collections to your credit.
Yes.
Yeah. So, do social issues also find a place in your poetry, in your poems?
My poems covers everything, I think. Like my personal feelings, the feelings of my other people, and the socials also. I also write poems on social issues. Suppose some social happenings disturbs me. Suppose the death of some person, some poet or any person whom we respect, we love, then also I write poem. So it covers everything what I feel.
So your poetry is not just confined to one particular theme. There are a host of themes that come under your poetry.
Yes.
Now a very difficult question. Which is your favorite, most among all your books and poems, collection of poetry, which is your favorite book and poem?
I don't know.
That's why I said it's very difficult.
Yeah, I don't know. Very difficult
to pick
select
up one
poem from all my...
All are very close to your heart.
Actually, after I write it, that means I have, I have expressed my feelings. So it is not inside now. So
yes.
I have already created a poem of my emotion. Then after that, I don't read my poems.
Okay, so you don't cross-check or edit it?
No.
Once you've written it, that's once and for all.
In time of publishing, sometime I correct my poems, sometime a few poems. But generally, I don't read
you
my
don't read
poems
them.
After I write it, because it is only my expression of my soul. So when I write it, that means it's over. Yeah.
Okay. It was a pleasure to have you here in the studio. Thank you so much for taking out your time and being here with us. Every woman is special in her own way. All we've got to do is take a look inside. On this International Women's Day, I urge and request every woman who's watching us right now to take pride in how different you are. Take pride in how unique you are. Embrace all the differences, all the flaws that you have. Don't chain yourself to one particular definition or concept. Instead, use the word woman as an agent of change, as an agent of celebrating your womanhood. On that note, I, Ridhi Sharma, on behalf of Doordarshan, take leave of you. Keep watching Doordarshan. Celebrate your existence. Celebrate your womanhood. Namaskar.